Hello, my name is Dr. Dmitry Tsvetov, and the topic of today's video will be wisdom teeth and orthodontics. I believe it's a very important topic to discuss because orthodontics, of course, is a very prevalent procedure that a lot of people undergo. Many people have braces, but what a lot of people don't realize is that the presence of the wisdom teeth can, in fact, negatively affect the duration as well as the outcome of orthodontic treatment. Let's look at some examples. On this screen here, you can see a perfect example where a developing wisdom tooth on the lower left is actually preventing the second molar on the same side from erupting or coming into the mouth normally. Now, the really disturbing part is this is actually the final orthodontic outcome. In other words, this patient already went through braces, was debonded, meaning the braces were removed, and this is the result they ended up with. Of course, as you can imagine, it's I would say suboptimal treatment, because ideally, especially after one would go through braces, you would want to expect that all of the teeth, including the second molar, are already completely out in the mouth. Another example here where we can see that on the lower right hand side, the second molar again is affected. As the wisdom tooth was developing, it was pushing the second molar to the front, and it became wedged underneath the first molar here. When we look at the situation on the left side, it is completely normal. Yes, the wisdom tooth is present, but the second molar was able to erupt normally. But here on the right side, clearly there is a problem. Here's a similar situation to what we just saw on the last slide, except now the problem is on the left, and again the developing wisdom tooth pushed the second molar basically underneath the first molar tooth over here. Yet another example of this similar situation. I'm not going to go into a lot of detail except to say that again, this is the final or the debonded result. We can see it by the presence of the permanent retainers in the front, meaning the patient already went through the braces were removed, the orthodontist cleared the patient completely, and yet this is the situation that the patient ended up with. Last but not least, not to belabor the point a lot, this is actually a situation where the top teeth are affected. So the bottom, to a certain extent on the bottom here, this tooth is a little bit lagging behind, again because of the wisdom tooth, but the main problem is actually on the top, where the presence of the wisdom tooth did not allow the second molars on both right side and the left side from erupting normally. The second molars on the top are basically wedged in between the first molar and the wisdom tooth. Again, this is another one of those examples where the patient went through the orthodontics, got the braces removed, the case is completed, but you can see that the result is not optimal. And the last slide, or the last x-ray I'm going to show you, is a patient that actually recently came into my office. He was referred for removal of the bicuspids, or the premolars, on the top, these two teeth over here. You can see the patient is still in braces, but what the orthodontist completely failed to catch is that the second molar here is not going to be able to come in because the wisdom tooth is in the way. Clinically, the situation actually looks a lot worse because this tooth was not even visible in the mouth, and the patient is already 13 years of age. These teeth, what we call the second molars, need to be out in the mouth by the age of 12, and if they're not, clearly there might be something that is going on. And as in this patient's case, the situation was that the wisdom tooth was preventing the second molar from erupting. So just to summarize, the second molars, which we also call 12-year-old molars, usually appear in the mouth at the age of 12. If they fail to appear, It's probably because the wisdom teeth are interfering. As you can see, the wisdom teeth can actually negatively affect the orthodontic outcome, because if the patient notices after the fact that the second molars are still not in, they might actually have to go through a second round of orthodontics. Whereas if the problem was caught earlier, then that would not be the case. So patients and parents are truly their own best advocates for their care, meaning one should really take an active role in their own orthodontic treatment. Talk to your orthodontist about the second molars, make sure they're erupting or progressing normally. And if there's any question at all, you can always schedule a free consultation with an oral surgeon to consult regarding the wisdom teeth. I thank you very much for your attention. I hope you found this video informative. And if you have any questions, please give our office a call at 951-302-9100.